Hello, my name is Gautam Kalita. Today we are going to learn about aluminium, its use in the construction industry. With the advent of aluminium, it has overshadowed the use of certain steel members due to its very much diversity of its constructional uses. So today we are going to learn aluminium, how it is extracted from certain mineral ores, its uses, as well as its importance. Its importance over other building materials like wood, steel, asbestos, etc. So, moving on to our first slide, here is an introductory part. As we know, aluminium is very much abundant in nature, which is present in various forms of oxides, sulfates, phosphates, etc. However, for commercial utilization, it is only extracted from the bauxite ore. As we know, for extraction of a metal from a mineral, certain criteria are being taken into consideration, of which economic extraction is one of the major aspects, because economy plays an important role in maintaining the market value of the metal, which will further gonna be used in the various form of industries. So, as you can see, aluminium, this is the bauxite, aluminium hydroxide from, it is a fused triolide. Now, what is a triolide? It is a double fluoride of aluminium and sodium, here you can see. Okay, so the aluminium is extracted from the bauxite ore, which is the hydrated oxide of aluminium manufacture. It is further ground and purified. It is dissolved in the fused cryolite, which is a double fluoride of aluminium and sodium. Okay, so moving on to our next slide. The manufacturing process occurs in two stages. The first stage includes the Baer's process, which is a chemical reaction, and the second phase includes the Hall-Héroult process. Okay, the Baer's process is very much simple. Here aluminium oxide is added with two molecules of sodium hydroxide, which gives in the product of two molecules of sodium aluminate plus one molecule of water. Again, sodium aluminate is reacted with two molecules of water, which is exothermic, which gives byproducts of aluminium hydroxide and sodium hydroxide. Here you can see that the OH molecules is replaced in the oxide form. Here this part is hydroxide part is easy to remove in presence of heat, as we know that, but oxide requires certain chemical processes. So here the aluminium hydroxide two molecules is used, which is treated in presence of heat in 1000 degree approx, which gives us the aluminium oxide plus three molecules of water. Okay, now coming to the Hall-Héroult process. The Hall-Héroult process requires a trim hole. It is a system where the insulation is provided above the ground. Again, then a steel casing is provided. Here you can see the steel casing is provided, which works as a barrier between the working system and the insulation cover. A fume hood, here you can see the fume hood is used to cover up the reaction process in order to control the hydrogen fluoride particulated exhaust, which would come out from the reaction. This wood is used, and a funnel here is placed. Here you can see here is a funnel is placed in order to properly wipe out the hydrogen fluoride. Okay, in this process what we do, we use a graphite cathode. Here you can see it is a process of where it is a process where like a chain process is used, where one part of the anode, here you can see this is the anode part. Okay, it's like a comb which is made of steel, fused coke anode. This is the coke part, the carbon part, which is used as anode. Here is connected with a steel spider, which is a comb like structure made of steel. This again is connected to the bus bar to the next cell. This reaction happens in chains. In industries, it don't occur like in a single process. It is a multiple collection of the Hall-Héroult process, which gives in the abundant quantity of aluminium. You can't extract more aluminium from a single Hall-Héroult jar. Okay, so the cathode portion is this graphite part, which is again connected to the next cell. So here what happens, the molten cryolite of alumina passed through the electrolytic process of anode and cathode, which in turn here it is the molten aluminum, which is which rests in the base due to the electrolytic process, and from the base it is extracted through a siphon edge pipe. Through this, here we can see the siphon edge pipe through which the aluminum is extracted from the electrolytic process. Okay, so moving on to the next slide, let's talk about the properties of aluminum. It's very strong. It is very strong compared to its very lightweight. It's easy to form, easy to move. It's easy to cast with different forms of due to its possibilities of creating many moldings and many kind of sections like C sections, U sections. It has grown importance over steel in the industrial construction industry. So it's perfect. We can see aluminum foils are being used for food packagings. It's a grit reflectors which are used in the light reflectors. Here you can see it is used as light reflectors as well. It's also a fireproof material. Also it's cryogenic, which means it can sustain very low temperature. It can it's also high resistant to fire. Also it's very cryogenic. In turn, it can could be used inside refrigerations also. It's very easy to recycle. It has a very long life, very little maintenance. It's used in superconductors for heat and electricity. You know, it's cryogenic, so it's used in superconductors. Okay, so it exhibits very luster on a fresh broken surface. Like whenever we need maintenance, a coat of aluminum paint would be sufficient to give it a very new look. So it has many importance in the construction industry. It's a non-magnetic substance which is very strong. The highly resistant towards corrosion and organic acids, malleable, very lightweight, very soft metal it is. It has a very high melting point, which is around 650 to 660 degrees centigrade, and it is a very high boiling point, which is around 2000 degrees centigrade. Its specific gravity stands at about 2.7. Okay, these are certain properties. Let's move on to the next slide. Okay, aluminium as a building material. Aluminium is a very important metal in the construction industry. There are various aspects which we can look into, like it's very airtight. There are very little chances that we could there would be a leakage in an aluminium airtight chamber. It's very much reliable. It has a very smooth appearance with a wide range of color scheme, which is available in its own aluminium paints. We have already talked about its cryogenic property. Behave normal at very low temperature as well, which gives it the cryogenic property. It's very easy in fabrication and assembling. There are various stages of fabrication, pre-fabrication, post-fabrication. These are certain sections of aluminium available which could be designed into specific type of requirements. Here you could see this building. This is one section. This is another section. These are various sections, individual sections, which could be fabricated and assembled to form a structure like this. Its handling and transportation is very easy. Since it is a very lightweight material, you could carry more of aluminium with a very little weight in it. So it is very highly resistant to corrosion properties and very highly resistive towards acids and certain chemicals. Due to its high reflectivity, it's used in lights and light reflectors. Here is another aspect. It has very high scrap value. Usually when we see metals, due to its corrosive properties, they usually lose their values in the long run. We could see that the scrap values of irons reduce them drastically due to its loss in weight due to the corrosions that occurs in them. But due to the certain properties of aluminium, it carries a very high scrap value. And also we know its high strength to weight ratio. Since it is a very lightweight material, the strength strength is compared very high compared to its very lightweight. These certain properties gives in another property, which is the maintenance cost. Due to the other properties of aluminium, the maintenance cost of aluminium drastically reduces in the long run, which gives in the economic factor a really good boost. So the economic use of aluminium. Aluminium is definitely expensive in the initial stage, since it is very very highly unlikely that you would find a corrosive aluminium, and certain durable factors and virtual eliminations of maintenance. Due to this such aspects, the initial costing of aluminium is quite high compared to like steel and wood. But in the long run, definitely it would cope up with the materials. So here are some comparisons. Like in asbestos, we know about asbestos. It is banned in certain countries due to its health hazards and issues like respiratory issues, which could come from asbestos cement. Asbestos is again 7 times heavier. Here you could see it requires very heavy structural support due to its own heavy weight, dead weight. So high maintenance. It requires very high maintenance as well. Okay, so aluminium is considered better than asbestos. Again, there is a comparison of CGI. This is the corrugated galvanized iron sheets, which is costly. This CGI sheets are costly than aluminium sheets and require more structural supports in comparison to the aluminium sheets. Now, steel is a perfect contender, which could come in a good competition with aluminium. So aluminium actually is the competitor to steel. Steel sections are available only in certain designs, like the C section, U section. But aluminium is something which you can mold. Here you can see the various shapes of aluminium sections. These are certain parametric shapes. Here you can see the parametric shapes of aluminium. Okay, this kind of sections are round sections are available in steel as well, but you can't possibly expect steel to be this much malleable that it would give us like this parametric sections, which is the only reason that aluminium in today's construction industry stands a step ahead of steel. Coming to timber, as we know, is a natural resource. The first thing that would come to our mind are trees in this time of global warming. Obviously, we need replacement of timber. No doubt, timber is a very durable material, which is also like used as a vernacular product in the construction industry. However, in the long run, aluminium acts as more durable. Also, replacement of timber is very much necessary to save the forestry. Okay, so here is this is a little comparison of aluminium with other building materials. Let's move on to the other slide. So now we should talk about the availability of aluminium in the market. Like, in what are the forms in which aluminium is available? Okay, aluminium is available in the casting form. Here you can see these are the casting molds. Then it is used in powder-based form, which are again used as aluminium paints. And again, it is available in extrusion-based forms, like these are extrusion-based sections of aluminium, which is available in the market. Again, it's sheet-based form. Aluminium sheets, we know it is used as, here you can see it is used as foil papers for food packaging industries. As well as it is used in the construction industries in aluminium sheets, the new kind of roofing systems that are being introduced in the market, which are quite inexpensive compared to the older versions. Nowadays it is very much available. Okay, let's move on. So the casting based utilities of aluminium are like the casting of baluster heads. These are the balusters. Used in the staircases. Okay, the heads of these balusters. The head of the balusters are certainly molded with molten aluminium, which are poured into moldings of wood, or like they are also molds are also made up of concrete as well. So the hardware and fittings, like the sanitary fittings, these are certain sanitary fittings that could be molded out of aluminium. The door lock security systems, these are the systems that could be molded out of aluminium. These moldings are generally of concrete moldings. Usually wood is not used for moldings that require security and decorative grids, because wood is again an expensive part. So let's move on from casting based to the extrusion based. Extrusion based is the availability of aluminium, like in rectangular sections. It comes in long pipes. Again, it's extruded at certain lengths as per the requirement of the sections. If we require 2 meter length, 3 meter length, 1 meter length, it is extruded based on the requirement. So these extrusion based aluminium sections are used in various construction elements, like the doors and window frames. Here you can see the Northern Light. This frame, whole frame, is made of extrusion based aluminium, which is cut into required sections of required length. Again, nowadays we could see many contemporary construction techniques like this one. This is a space frame truss, which is a double layered double glass layered roofing system, which is used nowadays for parametric roof designs. These circular sections are made of aluminium. So with the availability of material, we could see many innovations in the construction industry. These are the aspects of aluminium. The geodesic domes are properly reinforced with aluminium. Again, hardware and fittings. This is the Northern Light I have talked about. So moving on to the next slide. Powder based. We know about the deluxe tread of aluminium paint. It is used as decorative laminates. Again, due to its availability in various forms, like nowadays kinetic exterior walls are being, facades are being used, which are certainly the aspects of aluminium due to its possibility of molding into certain shapes. You could see here in the facade, these are aluminium plates. These give perforations for proper ventilation of air. Usually what happens in very hot and dry climatic regions, hot air is multiple times distracted from one surface to another, it loses its heat, initial heat, which gives a cooling effect to the air. So this kind of construction techniques are being used nowadays with the availability of aluminium. Aluminium paints are very glazy. Like the metals, iron, galvanized iron, metal parts are usually painted with aluminium paints, as it has these non-corrosive properties, which protects the galvanized iron sections from corroding over the long run. So it generally increases the lifespan of the metal structure. It could also be used as waterproofing sheets. So moving on to our next slide, sheet-based aluminium is very much popular. The cable tray business, this is a new kind of interior element of nowadays. Oh, it is very much used in offices and laboratories. Obviously, cable trays are like cable carriers. Also, the light fittings could be used in here. Flat type false ceilings could be used. Here you could see an aluminium false ceiling. This is the aluminium false ceiling. prefabricated housing. The prefabricated housing, the sections, construction elements that are required for prefabricated housings could be extruded from aluminium sheets. Here you can see these are aluminium sheets that are used, that are being used in the prefabricated construction. Usually, when we start construction, it usually requires 2 to 3 months for a proper construction. With the advent of the prefabricated system, which have developed from the advent of aluminium, the construction speed is very much lower. Nowadays, we could construct a house within 15 days due to this new prefabricated system of housings. Roofing slides, gutters, these are certain uses of aluminium sheets that could be molded into circular loops, which are used in gutters. These are certain uses of sheet-based aluminium. Let's move on to the next slide. Okay, these are the certain uses. It is reducing agent in the manufacturing of steel. In the manufacturing of steel, what happens? The aluminium powder is used as a reducing agent. Aluminium alloys are available, which is very much used in the automobile industry as well. There are different types of uses that would tell about the uses of aluminium apart from the construction industry. The various sections of aluminium are used in like automobile industries, in casting of steel. In the casting of steel, aluminium molds are used. Again, the use of aluminium could be seen in manufacturing of electrical conductors, the wires. It is again used in the manufacturing of frames, which the frame is again used as a non-corrugating material over iron and galvanized iron. Various galvanized iron sections used in the other industries as well. So these are these different parts of a building. Here you could see where aluminium could be used. The doors, the fans, the shutters, the balcony, the window frames and windshields. Again, these are extruded aluminiums. The garage doors, the various shading devices available, contemporary shading devices available nowadays. The curtain walls, the mullions used in the curtain walls, these are called the mullions. These are called the mullions, which are again made of aluminium. The roofing tiles, various type of roofing tiles used nowadays, these are roofing tiles which are again constructed from aluminium. The chimneys, solar panels, so you can see that almost the whole building is constructed out of aluminium. So moving on to our next slide. Aluminium as an alloy. Okay, aluminium in the construction industry, in architectural and structural applications, there are certain gradings used for the aluminium. Okay, we only use aluminium with these gradings 3003, 6061 and 6063, which are for architectural purposes like the tilings and finishes. Again, we have the structural applications of grading number 2024. 6061 is both used in architectural as well as structural applications. Structural applications are like the mullions used in the curtain wall, which provide structure to the stability to the curtain wall. So there are various alloys or aldural alloy, which is a thick coating of pure aluminium and duralumin. Aluminium bronze is available, where 10 to 22% of aluminium in base as copper. Okay, the duralumin is an alloy where aluminium 94% is available, copper is available in 4%, the rest of 2% is is equally divided among magnesium, manganese, silicon and iron constituents. The Y alloy, which is available, is in the form of aluminium 92.5%, copper is used in 4%, nickel is in 2% and magnesium in 1.5%. Okay, you could see the contemporary alloy wheels that are used in the racing cars nowadays. These are made of the duralumin. Okay, now moving on to our next slides. Aluminium grades. We have already spoken about the availability of aluminium grades and the various grades used in the construction industry, like flat sheet, expanded mesh, etc. are alloy 303. Typical applications of them are the wheels, the wheel bearers. These are aluminium 3003 grades. The extrusion based aluminium sections are again 3003 aluminium grade. So the commercial aspect, looking at its commercial aspect, there are various industries that deals with the aluminium manufacturing and marketing. Some of them are this Hindalco, Balco, Nalco and Jindal, of course. Jindal is the tycoon. And aluminium in the Indian market, it's available in very viable cost at ₹350 per kilo. The cost of iron is around ₹75 per kilo, though it's a bit expensive than iron, but in the long run it provides more durable and very low maintenance. Now let's talk about the 6061 alloy. It's available in the round bars. These are aluminum 6061. These are filled bars. You could see earlier in the previous this is the here you can see these are hollow sections. Okay, this 3003. Now it's just a purpose of identification. Yes, if you could see this hollow part, it's definitely alloy 3003 of aluminum. And you could see these are solid sections. Here you could mark it is an alloy of 6061 of aluminum, which are available in different forms: rectangular bars, square bars, hexagonal bars, channel beams, and angles, flat sheets. These angles are again used in the trussing of ropes, the perforated sheets. Okay, these are various forms available in the market. The typical applications, obviously, here you could see the machinery, various machinery parts, truck bodies, frames, running boards, steps. The aluminum steps are available nowadays. Walkaways are available. Again, these ramps. Yeah, ramps are constructed out of aluminum. In any structure, if aluminum is something like you could convert it into any required structural form, in any kind of form which you require. Okay, here you could see these are used in ramps. These things you could also see in the floorings of trains. This provides support to against slippery. These are also used in hospitals and shopping malls, the ramps. Okay, now moving on to the next. This is aluminum 6063. It's not a bit different from the grade 6061. Almost same as the previous grade of alloy of aluminum, just that it's a bit of low grade. Here you could see the only difference is the difference in the price. It's available at ₹250 per kilo, while this one is available at ₹350 per kilo, the aluminum 6061. So usually what happens, the temporary works that are required in the construction industry, like the moldings and extruded frames for stores, and again in like construction tubes, lawn furnitures, this kind of air cylinders, this kind of equipments are constructed out of alloy 6063 due to its economic aspect available in the market. These alloys are again provided by Hindalco, Balco, Nalco, Jindal. These are certain commercial groups that extrudes aluminium as well as molds it into desired shapes. So thank you.